I just finished at Global Television's The Morning Show, and Jeff and I were chatting about Kevin Hart's very public social media admission that, yes, in fact, he did cheat, he feels remorseful, and he was being extorted for doing so. As usual, I ran out of time and didn't get to say everything I wanted to say about this issue because I talked too much. Also, my Insta story face filters aren't working. So here's what I have to say about cheating in the digital age. First and foremost, cheating data has not increased. So the number of people who admit that they cheat on their partners has not increased. Now, does that mean more people aren't doing it? No, it's for liars. Searching for data on cheating prevalence, I found studies suggesting that the rates hover around 1%. I found other studies that were as high as 85%. A big part of it has to do with how they collect the data, who's in the room, and how they define cheating. Aggregate data from 31 studies suggests that the cheating rate is somewhere between 20 to 25% for married people, and it's higher for unmarried people in relationships. Data from college students suggests that between one-third and one-half of college students in relationships have cheated on their partner. I'm interested to see if cheating rates decline, especially with younger daters, as they are offered more options with regard to, for instance, consensual non-monogamy. I'm interested as to whether or not choice equates to greater honesty. But back to Kevin Hart. I see so much judgment online. People are very angry at him, and I really want to say something about judgment. Moral judgment in particular. Sorry, I saw two dogs. I'm here at the Shangri-La. Hi, doggies. Back to moral judgment. Moral judgment is often the most common and the most intense, and I believe that moral judgment is a matter, in most cases, of looking for your own deficits in others. The psychology of judgment suggests that we are really passing off our own perceived weaknesses, flaws, by looking for them in others. And sometimes judgment, as in perhaps the case of Kevin Hart, is a matter of fear. Fear that we might do the same, or fear that our partners will do the same. But judging him does nothing to protect your own relationship. Judging Kevin Hart and other people who cheat is our way of saying, I'm not like that, I'm different, I'm trustworthy. But if we value those traits, characteristics, values in ourselves, why don't we focus on developing them within ourselves rather than looking for their absence in others? Passing judgment or attacking him online doesn't make you more trustworthy. It doesn't cultivate trust in your relationship. That's work you've got to do on your own. So if you find that passing judgment is your way of avoiding that work, it's time to look in the mirror. And I know I'm guilty of this. It's not like I'm saying, here's me who really gets it and here's you who don't. I screw up all the time. I definitely pass judgment, and so I have to check myself and say, all right, what's really going on here? Are you frustrated with yourself? I remember reading The Art of Happiness interviews with the Dalai Lama many years ago and learning a lot about why we pass judgment and how we can reduce our inclination to judge. One strategy that really resonated with me from this book, The Art of Happiness, involved looking for the basic good in everyone, because there aren't good people and bad people. Ultimately, we all have so much good in us. Another strategy that really works for me involves thinking about other people's vulnerabilities, because when we deem someone's behavior inappropriate or immoral, we forget that they're just human, vulnerable, imperfect like us. And finally, we can resist the urge to judge by simply looking within ourselves and saying, this is what I like about myself, because when I like something about myself, I'm less likely to be critical of that same element in somebody else. So for example, if I feel I'm a good partner, or I feel I'm a good parent, or I feel I'm a good employee, I'm less likely to look for the deficits in others in those areas. I'm not saying it's easy, but I don't think the internet pylon that Kevin Hart is experiencing does anything to support him or his partners. In fact, I think the online judgment in the court of public opinion makes everything worse for him, but also for his partners, his past partners. So let's back off. And if our rush or inclination to judge is really rooted in our own fear that our partners might cheat on us, talk to your partner about it. Talk to them about what cheating means. Just that conversation can stave off cheating.